So let's look into ones and twos complement. Yeah. So first of all, program will often require to represent both positive and negative integers. So far we have only covered positive integer. So to get negative integers, we'll normally do two consecutive steps. We will first reverse the bits and then we'll just do a plus one. So what we do here, we will first reversing the bits. So we will convert the numbers into ones complement. So by reversing the bits, we actually get the ones complement form. And the next step, we just convert it into twos complement, which is our final answer. So we'll just do a plus one after step A. Yeah. So if you look at this, this is a binary form. It's just that instead of having positive 1, 2, 8 here, in the 2's complement sense, it will be 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, and the 8 bits will be negative numbers. So it'll be negative 1, 2, 8 instead of positive 1, 2, 8. So this is very important for 2's complement. You just have to remember that the 8 bits will always be negative 1, 2, 8 here. Therefore, using this table itself, we know that maximum positive number in 8 bits 2's complement form will be 127 due to 0, because since this cannot be 1, because if it's 1, it's going to be negative 128, so it will be 0, and the other bits will be all 1, yeah. So 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, so this will be 127. And for negative number in 8 bits 2's complement form, will be negative 128, since what we're going to do here is that we're just going to do a 1 on 8 bits, and after that we'll be having 0 for the remaining bits, yeah. Therefore, in 2's complement form, any integer that is more than 127, which is the maximum positive number, or less than negative 128, will result in overflow. So later on, we'll be just doing some example to actually show you how overflow will take place. So how to get 2's complement? So let's just do a quick walkthrough on how we can actually get 2's complement. So first of all, let's have this question. Express negative 30 in 1's complement and 2's complement. So the question is asking us to actually find out what is the 1's complement for negative 30 and what is the 2's complement for negative 30. Yeah. So first of all, we always start from the positive number. So the positive 30 will be this number, and then it will be 0011110. So this is a normal binary form. This is a number that represents positive 30. So to get 1's complement, just to do a recall, we will just reverse the bits. So what we do here is that we just reverse all the bits for this number. So 0 will go to 1, this 0 will go to 1, this 0 will go to 1, this 1 go to 0, this 1 will go to 0, this 1 will go to 0, this 1 will go to 0, and this 0 will go to 1. So basically this is the way to actually get 1's complement. Basically you are just doing bits reversing. The next thing we're going to do is just getting the 2's complement. So what we're going to do is that we just plus 1 from the previous step. So look at this number here, we're just going to add 1 here. So it will be 1 plus 1, we'll get 0, and we have a carryover of 1. So it will be 1 here, and the other will remain the same since we don't have any carryover from other bits. So the final answer will be 1110 0010 here. So definitely to double check, you can always take this number, this 1100010, and then you can just recalculate the final number. So it'll be just negative 128. Just remember that this is the last bit. So it'll be negative 128 plus 64 plus 32 plus 2, and you get negative 30. Yeah. So this is how you actually can get 2's complement. Yeah.